Hi, what's going on, peeps? My name is Simon. You're watching Soundwave TV, transforming your video experience. Okay. Hope everybody's having a productive, happy 2020. We got to clear out some backlog from the old year first. This is the losers list for 2019. Everybody took an L in the year of 2019. All right, getting into number 10, the Ben 10 Hive. So, Death Battle's a channel on YouTube. They do simulated fights, and they were upset for like 2 weeks because Ben 10 lost in a fight against the Green Lantern. And I'm like, guys, it's a fictional fight, a hypothetical fight between two fictional characters. It ain't that deep. I didn't realize that Ben 10 Hive was that strong, you know, considering he's a rather newer character, only debuting in 2006. Okay. There you go. Number 9, Game of Thrones fans. It's like, it's not enough you have like the biggest show ever. You're part of the biggest fan base ever. Now they want them to rewrite. They want to reshoot. They had petitions out to reshoot the last season because they didn't like how some of the storylines played out. I'm like, that's not happening. Like, not ever. It's like, the whole thing is like, why did they have a Starbucks cup on the set? It's like, they had complete senioritis. Like, it's like, these are the last episodes. We're going to cut them. We're out of here. All right. Number 8, Miles Garrett. Now, dude, you can't be hitting people in the head with a helmet when they ain't got no helmet on their head. I mean, he's been indefinitely suspended. He's a Browns defender and a Cleveland Browns defensive lineman. And it's just like, he's been indefinitely suspended. And it's like, you just threw away millions of dollars because you mad. It's like, the game was already over. Just take your L and go home. You had a whole game to be a tough guy. Now you want to get out here and be big and bad and bold, I guess. All right, Antonio Brown. This guy has had like 3 teams, another NFL player. Just not run your mouth. Do you have to run your mouth all the time? It's just like, you're a talented guy. Just keep your head down and just do what the team tells you to do. I mean, they're not asking you to do anything that's like illegal or immoral. It's just like, you was with the Steelers. You whine and moan, so you got to the Raiders. You couldn't make it work out there. And then you got to the Patriots and messed that up too. It's like, I guess, I don't know, man. Just trying to just like, I guess he's on a tour to play for every AFC team. All right. Number 6, Dark Phoenix. This is like, that movie was dead on arrival as soon as that Fox deal went through. You should have put it out 2 years ago. This movie was supposed to come out maybe think like the end of 2017, and they kicked the can, only to end up not making any money anyway. They're like, this is the last one. You could at least had Wolverine show up for like a hot second. You'd have, like, just go crazy. Like, this is the last movie. Like, add Deadpool or something. That would have brought people to the theater. It would have made sense, but none of the movie made sense anyway. All right, number 5. South Dakota PSA. Now, South Dakota apparently has a bit of a drug problem. So their message was meth. We're on it. Like, no one gave that like a second read. It's like, guys, it's like you're saying we're on meth instead of like meth. We're on it. It's like, I don't know. It's just like, I hope the people of South Dakota can get off the drugs, if they're on drugs, but it's just like, the whole thing just ended up being a big joke because nobody took the time to sit down and just proofread, copyright, you know, like, not copyright, yeah, just proofread, just like, go over the copy and make sure it doesn't sound weird or misleading. All right. Number 4, Varsity Blues. Now, the Operation Varsity Blues, apparently all these people were paying money to get their kids into school or whatever. And, you know, Felicity Huffman, you know, she went and cooperated with the feds, but she ended up getting like 14 days sentenced and only did maybe like 10. And I guess it's not, like, nobody got hurt or killed or anything, but it's just like, what's the old girl from Full House? Becky. Lori Loughlin. You know, she ended up paying all that money to get a kid in the USC, and it's like, it was like $500,000. For like $500,000, my kid better get into Hogwarts. Like, my kid better get into UA with his choice of quirk, because, like, I'm not paying all that money to get in USC. I mean, I can see you like a private, like a Harvard or Yale or Princeton or something, but she paid all that money, and then the girl, her daughter has a YouTube channel. She didn't even want to go to school in the first place. That's the kicker. I mean, that's crazy. Anyway, all right, number three, Jussie Smollett. Now, he had this harebrained idea that he was going to get a bigger part on Empire. He's going to, like, stage, like, attack. Like he said, these white guys beat him up and said, you know, these homophobic, you know, racist slurs to him. And then, you know, he was, like, slow about giving up the, the phone. And, you know, just like you start, the gears start turning people's heads, and they're trying to feel like, why is somebody going to go out in sub-zero degree weather to beat up the number five guy on the number four show on the number three network? He did all of that to try to get a bigger part on Empire, only to find out Empire's getting canceled anyway after this year. So it's like, the show's getting canceled, but the star's asking for a bigger trailer. It's just like, it's ridiculous. All right. Number two, President Trump. Now, we can do a whole video on the things that have been going on in the White House, but it's just like, Clemson Tigers won the national championship, and it got those boys, took those boys all the way from South Carolina to Washington, D.C., and gave them McDonald's. Why are you going to have them come three, four states over to give them the same thing they could have got the road? Now, again, I haven't been to Clemson in several years, but I'm pretty sure they have a McDonald's there. But, you know, I guess, you know, they got to see the White House or whatever. But it's just like, they didn't have like a space heater or something to keep the food hot for them. I don't know. But, you know, not the worst thing that could happen. But it's just like, guy, it's like, if you go and bring everybody all that way, you could, it's Washington, D.C. I'm pretty sure there's a home-cooked meal they could have got that one of the restaurants could have made for them. All right. Number one, R. Kelly. It's just like every interview with this guy is a train wreck. I done gave y'all 30 years of my life. You can't do this to me. It's just like, and Gail just looking at this guy just like, Robert. Like every interview he does is a train wreck. Gets worse. Like Ed Gordon, Torrey, old girl from the Huffington Post. Yeah, like every interview ends up being a train wreck. Now, that R. Kelly documentary came out. It's going to bury old dude. And he ended up, I figure, like, he didn't even have enough money to post bail. I feel like all them hits he got, he ain't got enough money to post bail to get him out of the lockup. It's just crazy. Well, anyway, that's my thought about who, all the people who took big L's in 2019. Who do you think is going to be taking L's coming up in the new year of 2020? Put in the comments down below. Hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell to find out about future videos. Until next time, this is Soundwave signing off. Peace.